Hi.
Hey.
I'm Felix.
And I'm Andres.
And welcome to Felix and Andres' cooking show. Today, in honor of Dia de los Muertos, we're going to be making you guys some salsa.
Salsa is Spanish for sauce. And without the sauce, you're lost.
That, did you plan that?
No.
You didn't write that down? You didn't
no, this is top my noggin.
You're brilliant, man.
Sure I am.
All right. So, to start us off, we've got multiple ingredients, so we're going to start off with some diced tomatoes.
We have fresh ones right here, but we don't like fresh things around here.
It's better, you know, it's more reliable to go with the diced. They're already canned.
Right here, we have some cumin. We're going to use it for some stuff. As well as,
we got some Pittsman's. It's Pittsman's mustard, mustard seeds. So we really add the spice.
We got some heat peanuts. I don't know why
they weren't even mentioned in the ingredients. But you know what? Sometimes you gotta add your own twist.
We got some weird things that grow in the ground. I don't know what they are. We're just gonna use them.
I think one of them's cloves. Something.
Yeah, use that stuff nicey hot.
Leaves. Yeah. All right. So we're cracking open the tomatoes. These smell awful.
Can I see it first? I'll give it a smell. Delicious!
I'm not gonna do it.
Wow. Do you wash dishes in the rain?
No, we don't. I mean, sometimes we wash them in the rain.
That's right. Right now, you should be washing everything else. But
instead,
okay.
Instead, you forced me to come to this stupid cooking show with you. Okay, so next up, actually we're going to save the mustard seeds for last, obviously, because they're the most important ingredient. We're going to do some cumin. Many recipes are going to say go light on the cumin. We're not about that. Cumin's a great taste, really Mexican culture, just embodied in the salsa. So we're going to go heavy on the cumin, right? Sometimes you're not able to get enough cumin out, so you're just going to want to take the little lid off. And you're just gonna want to dump more cumin in. So
that's a lot of cumin.
We're talking about a fourth of a cup of cumin.
It smells.
So yeah, it's gonna smell. It's gonna give off a good taste, a good smell, and a good aroma.
Next is garlic. I like garlic. We can do some cool stuff with garlic, but we're not gonna prepare it the traditional way. We're gonna do it our own way. We're just gonna.
So the scissors. Actually bring out a more intense flavor in the garlic. And you're able to just, cut it the way you like, where if you're cutting it with a knife, you're more restricted.
That was too close. Put as much garlic as you want in there. We love garlic around here.
It doesn't matter how much garlic you put in, it just matters that the garlic's there. This is also an onion, same sort of procedure. You want to go from the side and just cut the, try to cut the top off like that.
Yeah.
If you can't, it's okay. You can just try to bite into it like that, and then you're just gonna stick it. If the scissors stick, then you know you did it right. And you just wanna do that. Similar to what a knife would do, but the scissors, it's double penetration, so it's more. We're gonna break it open, and you just kind of want to put the whole thing in.
Maybe not the entire thing.
All right, so just a half. You can. All right, so as you can see so far, we're doing pretty well. It looks good. Cumin, obviously, probably the most important flavor. But staying true to Mexican culture, you know those Mexicans like their chocolate.
Those Aztecs. Oh, you have no idea. There's a lot of interesting history about Aztecs and their chocolate.
Absolutely. A famous Aztec sauce is beans and chocolate together. They're really good. So Andres is just preparing the onion. I'm just gonna try a little bit of that. Alright. So
pretty good, isn't it?
I'd say it's pretty good. You're gonna wanna go with about normal recipes would have you put about 2 to 3 cups of this chocolate sauce in. We're just gonna say about you know, a fourth of a cup, just like the cumin. So you just want to, you know, blast it in there.
Oh wow, that's a lot.
It's gonna look pretty dark, you know. Gonna give you really the flavor that you want.
I wanna get it close up of that.
You can take a look.
Oh wow, that's
pretty incredible.
Delicious.
Really mixes with the tomatoes for an intense flavor. So last up, we're gonna go with the Pittsman's.
I love Pittsman's mustard.
Andres' favorite, my favorite. You know, everybody loves Pittsman's mustard. They're also paying for this show. Or should I say that?
You can say it if you want.
Okay. Yeah. So we're being. All right. I'm just not gonna talk about the sponsorship. Anyway, Pittsman's. You know, really important part of most, you know, Spanish families in Latin America. You can really smell the heritage in the seeds. So we're just gonna go, you know, similar to the cumin, you know, it's difficult to get out. You see these small holes, you know. For Leah Dukevich, you're just gonna wanna take a look at these holes here. So you can actually take the lid off, similar to cumin. You're just gonna want to power that in. So, Andres, you want to show them a close up here?
Yeah, that's right there. Looks so authentic.
So it really adds that extra little bit of flavor.
And so next step is just to mix it all up. All right, so the whole next step of this process to stir it and make it all blended in there like one giant mash. So.
You know what they say?
La cocina muy desorganizada, which means if you're not making a mess,
you're not doing it right. You just want to get all of that in. I'm going to take over here, Andres. I want to really show the camera just how important it is to be aggressive with your mixing. And you really want to make sure that you're getting the most out of your kitchen. So I don't know if you can see that, but I'm really mixing it mixing it well here. So sometimes obviously you're gonna look, you can see we've lost a little bit here. Really easy way to fix that. You're just gonna want it. And there we go. We're back at it. There we go. And we got all of our sauce back in the bowl. Just want to get back at it. You know, if your hands are clean at the end of the salsa making, then you did it wrong, okay? That's probably the number one rule. Actually, I would call it the number two rule. After having fun, you really want to have fun in this whole process.
A brief history of Dia de los Muertos. Or Day of the Dead. It takes place November 1st and 2nd, often in the United States and Mexico, especially in this general region where there's lots of Hispanic heritage and culture. It is a huge parade every year that takes place right there in Mexico City. It's a massive parade in the largest city in North America. It has lots of Aztec influence, and about the Day of the Dead, it's a lot to do with the mourning of the souls. But it's also a festival. What some people may think is an often sad thing, it's often makes people quite happy because it's a really joyful season. The food and offering is usually calacas, which are skulls made of sugar, and pan de muertos, which is bread of the dead, which is bread shaped like people.
Thank you. between Dia de los Muertos and Halloween.
Dia de los Muertos. Oh, I don't know.
Halloween takes place on October 31st. The other one doesn't suck.